Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Wang. Here is the question. We want to simplify the sum of two log functions with the same base square root of 2, log sine 7 pi over 8 plus log sine 3 pi over 8. This is a very good question for exercise to test if you know the fundamental formulas from algebra and the trigonometry. Here is the sum of two logs, which formula we can use. The sum formula for two logs with the same base equals log of the product. Sometimes you use it backwards. Log of the product equals sum of two logs. So here in our case, what is A? A is the square root of 2. This formula only for the same base log functions. So what is B here? B is 7 pi over 8. What is C? 3 pi over 8. We can put that sum of two logs into one log equals log of sine 7 pi over 8 times sine 3 pi over 8. What's next? Continue to simplify. What is this? 7 pi over 8, 3 pi over 8. We can rewrite them into the following. 7 pi over 8 equals pi minus pi over 8. 3 pi over 8 equals pi over 2 minus pi over 8. If you don't see this, you can see that's 2 pi over 8. Sorry, that's 4 pi over 8. Continue to simplify. What kind of formula can we use? What is this part? You can find the reference angle. Reference angle, that's pi over 8 in the first quadrant. So this angle actually in the second quadrant, sine in the second quadrant is still positive. So here, first part, we can drop pi, use the reference angle, pi over 8. So sine pi minus pi over 8 equals sine pi over 8. What is this part? What kind of formula can we use? That's sine pi over 2 minus alpha equals cosine. This is the formula to convert sine function into cosine function. Some of you maybe don't familiar with half pi. If I switch half pi to 90 degree, if we use the degree measure, you know that. Sine 90 degree minus alpha equals cosine alpha. We use this formula for the second part. So here, log first part equals sine pi over 8. The reference angle is pi over 8. Second part, that's pi over 8. We converted sine into cosine. Which formula we can use now? Look at here, sine pi over 8, cosine pi over 8. We have the same angle here. Here's the formula, double angle formula. Sine 2 alpha equals 2 sine alpha times cosine alpha. So this part is this part. Alpha, in our case, that's pi over 8. We want to use the double angle formula to simplify inside part. Here we need to, we have 2 here, we don't have 2. So we can move 2 to the other side, divide by 2, which is 1 half. So here, everything is the same except this part. That's 2 alpha, sine 2 alpha. Sine 2 alpha. Time 1 half, 2 alpha. 2 times pi over 8, that's pi over 4. Sine pi over 4, that's a special angle. Square root 2 over 2. Simplify. Rewrite in this way. 2, that's a square root of 2 squared. Square root 2 squared. That's square root 2 to the power 4. Simplify both numerator and denominator. We have the same base here, square root of 2. So which is 1 minus 3 is power negative 3. Which formula we can use now? We are here. This is the formula. Log of a, base a, b to the power x. We can bring this x from inside to upstairs to downstairs outside. So x times log b with base a. So in our situation, x is negative 3, b is square root of 2. Base is also square root of 2. We bring negative 3 outside downstairs. That's negative 3. So here, which formula we can use now? Log a with base a equals 1. So what is this part? Our a is square root of 2 here. So this part is 1. The final result is negative 3. So here, the sum of 2 log, we can simplify to negative 3. Negative 3 is the answer. So here, for this problem, we use several formulas. The first formula we used, that's sum of 2 logs equals log of the product if they are having the same base. Second formula we used, that's a double angle formula, sine 2 alpha equals 2 sine alpha times cosine alpha. Then we use the formula, converting sine into cosine. Sine half pi minus alpha equals cosine alpha. Then we use the formula, log of b to the power x. We can bring x from inside to outside downstairs equals x times log b. The last formula we used, that's log a with the same base a here, equals 1. Remember, to solve this kind of problem, you have to be good to know those formulas. If you know those formulas, it will save you lots of time. When you simplify things like this, the first thing you need to do is if there's a formula. If there's a formula, it's always a shortcut to help you to simplify. That's all. Thanks for watching and see you next time.